So hello everyone and a very good morning to all of you. Welcome back once again to the session of PIB Current Affairs. In this video guys, as usually I will bring to you some more important questions from the PIB news which are relevant for all the government exams. Alright, so let's begin with the session. But before we begin, if you are coming here for the first time, do subscribe to the channel and press this bell icon. You can also join this Telegram group. Here you will get the PDF of this session after the session is completed. And you can also ask any doubt. You can also follow me here. Here also you can ask any doubt. So let's talk about the very first question, which says, what is the total financial outlay of incentive scheme to promote RuPay debit card and low value Bheem UPI transactions approved recently by Union Cabinet? Okay, so this is a recently launched incentive scheme, recently approved incentive scheme that has been approved by Union Cabinet. So the question is regarding the total financial outlay. Now let's try to understand what is this scheme basically. So remember, Union Cabinet has approved an incentive scheme to promote RuPay debit cards and low value Bheem UPI transactions in the country. Now what is the meaning of low value here? Low value ka matlab yahan pe hai, the meaning of low value is the transactions up to rupees 2000. Transactions up to rupees 2000. Okay, that is the meaning of low value here. Now as the name suggests, it is an incentive scheme, which means some kind of incentives will be provided. Now these incentives will be provided to whom? The question is this, ki abhi incentive kisko milega? So remember, the incentives will be provided to the banks. The acquiring banks will be incentivized by the government. Okay, and of course it is aimed at making accessible digital modes of payments to unbanked and marginalized population, because of course if the government is promoting RuPay debit cards and Bheem UPI transactions, then definitely the government is intended towards increasing the digital access to those, increasing the digital access to those people who are marginalized and who are out of the reach of this digital banking ecosystem. Okay, so the banks will be incentivized by the government. And what type of incentive is this, by the way? So remember, the incentive will be in the form of percentage of value of transactions done through RuPay debit cards and low value Bheem UPI transaction. And low value ka matlab maine aapko bata diya, up to rupees 2000. All right. Now how much percentage incentive of the value of transaction will be provided, that is not declared by the government. Wo jab detail mein aayega scheme, then we will discuss. Abhi tak itna hi bataya unhone, that the incentive will be provided in the form of percentage of value of transactions jo ki hui hai through RuPay debit card or through low value Bheem UPI transactions. All right, now the total financial outlay for this is rupees 1300 crore for this year, for this year's, that is from 1st of April 2021 up to 31st March 2022. So this scheme is effective from 1st of April 2021. All right, so abhi guys government ne itna hi bataya hai, PIB pe itna hi mila hai. So aage jab detail mein aayega, then we will discuss it again. So therefore the correct answer is what? Rupees 1300 crores, option A. 1300 crore iska sahi answer hai. The total financial outlay is 1300 crores. All right. Moving ahead to question number 2. What is the total outlay of the comprehensive program for the development of semiconductor and display manufacturing ecosystem approved by the Union Cabinet? So this is one more scheme which has been recently approved by the Union Cabinet. And remember, इस स्कीम में से कोई बहुत डीप क्वेश्चन नहीं आ सकता, बिकॉज इसके जो टर्मिनोलॉजीज इसमें यूज हुई हैं वो बहुत ज्यादा टेक्निकल हैं, एंड उन टर्मिनोलॉजीज के बारे में एग्जामिनर को भी नहीं पता होता, एंड दैट्स व्हाई ही इज नॉट गोइंग टू आस्क यू क्वेश्चन फ्रॉम दैट. ऑलराइट, इसमें से बिल्कुल बेसिक क्वेश्चन आएगा, लाइक जैसा क्वेश्चन फाइनेंशियल आउटले टाइप का है, इस टाइप का ही क्वेश्चन आ सकता है. ऑलराइट, सो बेसिकली द स्कीम इज व्हाट? द स्कीम इज कॉम्प्रिहेंसिव प्रोग्राम फॉर द डेवलपमेंट ऑफ सेमीकंडक्टर and display manufacturing ecosystem in the country. This is the name of system. Basically the government intends to develop the semiconductor and display manufacturing market. Jo hamare semiconductor manufacturers hain ya fir display manufacturers hain, unki market ko uplift karna is the objective. All right, and again this is an incentive scheme. Incentive scheme hai ye. The government will provide incentive support to the companies which are engaged in semiconductor and display manufacturing. ठीक है, टोटल आउटले 76,000 करोड़ है. टोटल आउटले कितना है? रुपीज 76,000 करोड़. एंड दीज आर थ्री मोस्ट इंपॉर्टेंट टाइप्स ऑफ इंसेंटिव्स दैट विल बी प्रोवाइडेड. ठीक है, सबसे ज्यादा इंपॉर्टेंट यही तीन है, तो यही आपको याद रखने हैं, इससे ज्यादा डिटेल में जाने की देयर इज नो नीड. ऑलराइट, फॉर द पीपल हु आर एंगेज्ड इन सेमीकंडक्टर एंड डिस्प्ले डिस्प्ले फैब्रिकेशन यूनिट्स, ठीक है, फॉर दोज पीपल हु इंटेंड्स टू सेट अप दीज सेमीकंडक्टर एंड डिस्प्ले फैब्रिकेशन यूनिट्स, 50% ऑफ द टोटल प्रोजेक्ट कॉस्ट विल बी प्रोवाइडेड एज इंसेंटिव. ठीक है, जितना भी प्रोजेक्ट कॉस्ट होगा, मान लो कि सेमीकंडक्टर और डिस्प्ले फैब्रिकेशन यूनिट्स, सॉरी सेमीकंडक्टर फैब्रिकेशन यूनिट लगानी है मान लो लेट्स से मेरे को, एंड देयर इज अ टोटल कॉस्ट ऑफ रुपीज 1 करोड़, देन आउट ऑफ दिस 1 करोड़ 50 लाख विल बी प्रोवाइडेड एज इंसेंटिव बाय द गवर्नमेंट. ठीक है, फॉर दोज हु आर engaged in compound semiconductor or sensors, 30% of the capital 30% of the project cost will be provided, and for semiconductor designing 50% of the expenditure will be provided. ठीक है, अगर कोई कंपनी सेमीकंडक्टर डिजाइनिंग में काम कर रही है या करना चाहती है तो जो भी उनका खर्चा होगा उसका 50% गवर्नमेंट विल प्रोवाइड. ठीक है, सो दिस इज बेसिकली इज टू यू नो गिव अ बूस्ट टू दिस सेक्टर, सेमीकंडक्टर एंड डिस्प्ले मैन्युफैक्चरिंग सेक्टर, एंड देयरफॉर the correct answer is what, option D, rupees 76,000 crore, because that's the question. We have to tell the total outlay, and that's how much, 76,000 crores. Moving ahead to question number 3. Consider the following statements with respect to extension of Pradhan Mantri Krishi Sinchai Yojana, and you have to identify the correct statement. Now guys, if you want to know the details of Pradhan Mantri Krishi Sinchai Yojana, then you can search Anuj Jindal Government Schemes. There is a playlist of so many important government scheme, and there I have explained this Pradhan Mantri Krishi Sinchai Yojana very recently. Jab abhi NABARD ka exam hua tha tabhi explain kiya hai, so from there you can have an idea about this scheme. So let's talk about the news then. So the Union Cabinet Committee on Economic Affairs has extended the implementation of Pradhan Mantri Krishi Sinchai Yojana for a period starting from 2021 to 2026. theek hai, ab inhone ye nahi bataya yahan pe कि ये मार्च 2026 तक है या दिसंबर 2026 तक है, ऐसा कुछ नहीं बताया, इतना ही लिखा था पीआईबी में. सो 2021 से 26 यानी द स्कीम हैज बीन एक्सटेंडेड टिल 2026. ऑलराइट, नाउ रिमेंबर द टोटल आउटले इज हाउ मच, 93,068 करोड़, एंड एज यू ऑल नो देर आर 3 कॉम्पोनेंट्स अंडर प्रधानमंत्री कृषि सिंचाई योजना. नंबर 1 इज एक्सेलरेटेड इरीगेशन बेनिफिट प्रोग्राम AIBP, which is a program to provide financial support for irrigation projects. ये इस project में, इस program में क्या होता है, irrigation के लिए funding दी जाती है by the government. And during this period of 2021 to 26, there is a target to cover 13.88 lakh hectare area under the irrigation. मतलब irrigated area जो है उसको बढ़ाना है, और वो target कितना है, 13.88 lakh hectare of the area will be covered under the irrigation. ठीक है, under this program, under this component, accelerated irrigation benefit program. Moving ahead to the second component, which is हर खेत को पानी. Remember, it is a program for expansion of cultivable area under the irrigation. ठीक है, cultivable area under the assured irrigation, and the total target is 1.52 lakh hectare for this period of 2021 to 2026. And then we have a third component, which is watershed development, which focuses on the development of rain fed areas towards soil and water conservation and regeneration of groundwater. Okay, ab iski scheme ki details agar padhni hai to main fir se repeat kar deta hu, go to the playlist of government schemes, there you will find the details of this scheme. So now let's come back to the question then. It has been approved for implementation for a period 2021 to 25. That's not 25 guys, that's 26. Total outlay for the extended period is 1,030, नहीं ऐसा कुछ नहीं है, 93,068 करोड़ है, 93,068. And under accelerated irrigation benefit program, 12 lakh hectare area is targeted. नहीं, ये भी गलत है, 13.88 है ये, 13.88 lakh hectare area. तो that means कि हमारे पास option जो है वो गलत है, इसको incorrect कर लेते हैं, काम करते हैं, मैं पीडीएफ में चेंज कर दूंगा, डोंट वरी. लेट्स से द क्वेश्चन इज, वी हैव टू आइडेंटिफाई द इनकरेक्ट स्टेटमेंट, तो 2 and 3, अच्छा नहीं, ओके, नन इज करेक्ट हो जाएगा आंसर. यस, आइडेंटिफाई द करेक्ट, तो नन इज करेक्ट, बिकॉज तीनों के तीनों कैसे इनकरेक्ट है. ओके, सही है क्वेश्चन, कोई गलती नहीं है, नन इज करेक्ट हो जाएगा बिकॉज ऑल दी स्टेटमेंट्स आर इनकरेक्ट हियर. ऑलराइट, दिस इज अप टू 2026, दिस इज 93068 करोड़ एंड दिस इज 13.88 लाख हेक्टेयर. सो ऑल द स्टेटमेंट्स आर इनकरेक्ट, दैट्स व्हाई ऑप्शन डी इज द करेक्ट आंसर. नाउ लेट्स टॉक अबाउट क्वेश्चन नंबर 4. व्हिच कंपनी हैज साइंड एन एग्रीमेंट विद ग्रीन सेल मोबिलिटी फॉर डिप्लॉयमेंट ऑफ 350 इलेक्ट्रिक बसेस अक्रॉस 9 सिटीज ऑफ उत्तर प्रदेश. उत्तर प्रदेश के 9 सिटीज में इलेक्ट्रिक बसेस लगाना है एंड फॉर दैट एन एग्रीमेंट हैज बीन साइंड विद दिस ग्रीन सेल मोबिलिटी विच इज अ ई मोबिलिटी कंपनी. And this Green Cell Mobility works with the support of Government of India and Government of UK. Government of India or UK ke support se chal raha hai. Basically, it is a collaboration. Alright. And this company, guys, is Power Finance Corporation. Let's talk about this. Power Finance Corporation, PFC, which has recently got the status of Maharatna. I hope you remember this. Now, there are 11 Maharatnas in the country and 11th one is recently added, Power Finance Corporation. So this has signed an agreement for deployment of 350 electric buses across 9 cities of UP and the agreement has been signed with Green Cell Mobility, jo ki hame question mein pata chal gaya tha. And as I told you, it is an e-mobility platform supported by the governments of India and UK and the total project cost will be how much? Rupees 275 crores. 275 crore ka total cost hai ye, total project cost. So therefore the correct answer is what, option C, Power Finance Corporation. Power Finance Corporation is iska sahi jawab hai. Moving ahead to question number 5, consider the following statements with respect to textile workers rehabilitation fund scheme and you have to identify the correct statement. Now this scheme, ye scheme humne pehle kabhi nahi padhi hai, that's why we are discussing about this because it is in news, because in one of the replies given by the Ministry of Textiles, this scheme was mentioned. And who is the Minister of Textiles, by the way? Mr. Piyush Goyal. Piyush Goyal is the Minister of Textile. So let's talk about this scheme. Remember guys, the scheme was launched in the year 1986. Okay, it's a very old scheme. It was launched in the year 1986. Alright. And as the name suggests, Textile Workers Rehabilitation Fund, which means some kind of rehabilitation will be provided, is being provided to the textile workers. And for that, there is a fund. Okay. ये इसके नाम से हमें समझ में आता है. नाउ व्हाट काइंड ऑफ रिलीफ इज दिस? दिस रिलीफ इज प्रोवाइडेड इन द फॉर्म ऑफ अनएम्प्लॉयमेंट अलाउंस. किस फॉर्म में है? अनएम्प्लॉयमेंट अलाउंस में है. सो टू प्रोवाइड रिलीफ टू द वर्कर्स रेंडर्ड जॉबलेस ड्यू टू क्लोजर ऑफ नॉन स्मॉल स्केल इंडस्ट्रीज कंपनीज इन द प्राइवेट सेक्टर. ठीक है, इट वॉज लॉन्च इन द ईयर 1986. ऑफकोर्स द मिनिस्ट्री इज मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ टेक्सटाइल्स, बट रिमेंबर वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट थिंग हियर that starting from 1st of April 2017, 1 April 2017 के बाद से, the scheme has been merged with Rajiv Gandhi Shramik Kalyan Yojana. Rajiv Gandhi Shramik Kalyan Yojana के साथ ये merge हो गई थी. And as I told you, under the scheme, an unemployment allowance is provided. How much? To the extent of 50% of salary for initial 12 months and 25% of the salary from 13th to 24th month. मतलब 2 साल के लिए अनएम्प्लॉयमेंट अलाउंस प्रोवाइड कराया जाता है. ऑफ कोर्स इतने में तो जॉब लग जाएगी, तो पहले साल में 50% और दूसरे साल में 25%. ठीक है, सो इतना ही पढ़ना है, इससे ज्यादा डिटेल में जाने की जरूरत नहीं है. नाउ लेट्स आइडेंटिफाई द करेक्ट स्टेटमेंट. द स्कीम वाज लॉन्च्ड इन 1996, नॉट इन 1996, इट वाज 1986 व्हेन इट वाज लॉन्च्ड. सिंस 1/4/2017 इट हैज बीन मर्ज्ड विद राजीव गांधी श्रमिक कल्याण योजना, एब्सोल्युटली करेक्ट. And under the scheme, the unemployment allowance to the extent of 50% of salary for initial 12 months is provided, absolutely right. And for the next 12 months, it is 25%. So this is also correct. 2 and 3 will be the correct answer, option B. Option B will be the correct answer, 2 and 3. And now let's talk about the last question for today. That's question number 6. One-liner question, one-marker question hai, agreement pe hai. So इसमें डिटेल में जाने की जरूरत नहीं पड़ेगी. विद विच कंट्री यूनियन कैबिनेट हैज अप्रूव्ड द ट्रीटी ऑन म्यूचुअल लीगल असिस्टेंस इन क्रिमिनल मैटर्स टू एनहांस इफेक्टिवनेस ऑफ बोथ द कंट्रीज इन इन्वेस्टिगेशन एंड प्रोसिक्यूशन. ठीक है, क्रिमिनल मैटर्स में एमओयू है. कीवर्ड्स पकड़ा करो एमओयू के, हमेशा ट्राई टू फोकस ऑन द कीवर्ड्स. ट्रीटी ऑन म्यूचुअल लीगल असिस्टेंस इन क्रिमिनल मैटर्स, क्रिमिनल मैटर्स के रिस्पेक्ट में एमओयू हुआ है एक कंट्री के साथ, एक एग्रीमेंट हुआ है, एक पार्टनरशिप हुई है. And that country, guys, is Poland. Option B. Poland's capital is Warsaw. Warsaw is the capital of Poland. So option B is the correct answer. So that's it for the session today, guys. I hope all the questions are clear. If you have any doubts, you can ask me in the comment section. I'll see you on Monday with brand new session of PIB Current Affairs. Till then, revise karte raho. Saturday to Sunday ka time hai. Jo bhi ek hafte mein padha hai, usko revise kar lena. Goodbye, take care, and God bless.